let's start with the equations of angle between radius and radius vector and tangent. So the concept we have to use is tan phi is equals to r d theta by dr. So let's solve first question, which is says r square is equals to a square sine 2 theta. You need to find the angle between radius and tangent vector of this curve at theta is equals to I think pi by 2. So my fixed approach is, whenever you see this polar equation, step 1, take log both the sides. Take log both the sides. See, why I am taking log? There is a reason. When I take log, I got something like this. So when I differentiate it, I got 1 by r dr by d theta. So if I reciprocal it, I got r d theta by dr, which is nothing but it can be compared to, see, r d theta d phi is 10 phi. So I just can write it as 10 phi. So to get this phi. In this they are asking phi only, no? Are you getting it? So I use this kind of approach by taking log both the sides. Whenever you see the question of angle between the radius vector and tangent, or angle between two curves, or pedal equations, you have to use the same approach for your benefits. Okay? If you do by other methods, that is also correct. You know the differentiation another method? You have just to differentiate, no? Just get this form anyhow, but my approach is this, taking log both the sides. Okay? So when I take log both the sides, what I got it? I got it, can I write it as 2 log of r is equals to 2 log of a plus log of sine 2 theta. I think I got this. I have separated this, no? So now I am differentiating it. So you got it 2 dr by, so you got 2 by r dr by d theta is equals to 2 log a is a constant, so 0. For this I got sine 2 theta, differentiation of sine is cos 2 theta, differentiation of 2 theta is 2. So it cancels out this. So I got dr by r d theta as cos of 2 theta sine of 2 theta. Now if I reciprocal this, I got r of d theta by dr as sine of 2 theta cos of 2 theta. Now r d theta by dr is nothing but 10 phi. So I easily get this. So I can write 10 phi is equals to, now sine 2 theta upon cos 2 theta is 10 2 theta. So both are 10 r. So I can compare both. So from phi is equals to 2 theta. You got the value of phi, which is equals to 2 theta. And they are asking phi at pi by 2. So you just put the value of theta here. So your phi for this question will be 2 into pi by 2. That is, this is the answer for this question. So did you get the approach? First you need to take the log both the side. Get this kind of equation. Reciprocal it. Get 10 phi and solve it. Did you get this question? Okay. Let's do one more question to it. From basic, if you start, no, there is nothing new in it. So let's start with the second question, which says 2a by r is a 1 minus cos theta. You need to find phi at theta is equals to pi by 3. So my approach is fixed. So I have taken log 2a minus log r. So I am just taken this. I think you should not have any problem. Now I tell you one more thing, you people will make a mistake here. Some people will take like this, log 1 minus log of cos theta. Hey, you have to take log both the sides, no? So you have to like write like this, not like this. I have seen in many questions that people used to do like this only. Okay. Now differentiating it, this is a constant thing, so it will be 0. So it becomes 1 by r. dr by d theta is equals to 1 minus cos theta. The differentiation of cos theta is nothing but a sine theta, I must say. Oh, negative sine theta, no? Is it okay? Differentiation of this cos is negative sine theta, no? Then, what I can do is your, yeah. Is it correct, no? At pi by 3, you can add more angles, no? At pi by 4, you find both. Pi by 3 and pi by 4 you find. Is it okay? So, this gets cancels out. So, you got 1 by r dr by theta in this form only. So, reciprocal it, you got r d theta by dr as 1 minus cos theta upon sin theta. So, I know one thing, now you got stuck. This is 10 phi you got, but you are not getting this in terms of 10. So, whenever you see this kind of situation, I know one formula that cos 2 theta is equals to 2 cos square theta minus 1. Or else if you want to write 2, 1 minus sin square theta minus 1, that is 2 1 minus 2 sin square theta. And I know that sin 2 theta can be written as sin theta cos of theta. See why I have done like this? Because of you people only. You people do blunders in exams and you forget this kind of stuff. So whenever you see this kind of 1 minus cos theta, you should come up with these things. So if I take 1 minus cos, this cos theta as 2 cos square theta minus 1, this will not have an effect. But if I take this thing, so you got it 1 minus 2 sin square theta by 2 upon sin theta, I can write it 2 sin of theta by 2 cos of theta by 2. Is it okay? So I think if I remove this, I got this. This gets cancelled out. So I got r d theta by dr as 2 sin square theta by 2. So 1 sin will get cancelled out, 2 will get cancelled out. So according to me, I got, is it correct? Oh yeah. I got sin theta by 2 and cos theta by 2. So I think this is 10 phi and this is nothing but 10 of theta by 2. So phi is equals to theta by 2. So they were asking at theta x pi by 4. So it is pi by 6 when theta is pi by 3. And phi at pi by 4 is pi by 8. Is it okay? Is it okay or not? Let's do one more question on it. Because so this is an important concept, no? Okay, sometimes you may get this stuff also, I tell you. You should remember these results also. But 10 of A minus 10 of A can be written as 10 of, you know now, CAST. Okay, you can write pi minus A. Is it okay? Then cot of A can be written as 10 of pi minus A. Minus cot of A can be written as 10 of pi by 2 plus. So you remember these results also, they will help you. For example, if you got something called as r d theta by dr as cot of 2 theta. So this becomes 10 pi and this cot 2 theta from this can write as 10 of pi by 2 minus 2 theta. So from this phi is equals to pi by 2 minus 2 theta. Is it okay? So like this also. So remember this approach. Remember this cos 2 theta is 2 cos square theta minus 1, 1 minus 2 sin square theta. Sin 2 theta is 2 sin of theta cos C. See, I have gone to your level because I know what is the pain in this small stuff we have to feel. Okay, so let's do one more question and end with this, and I'll give some questions to you to solve. No, so let's see if it is given Rn is equals to An cos of n theta, find phi. So my approach is fixed, no? Take log the both side. I got log of R is equals to n log of A plus log of cos n theta. Differentiating it, I got n by R dr by d theta. This is constant term, so it will get cancelled out. I got cos n theta. Differentiation of cos is minus sin n theta, and differentiation of this n theta is n. Is it okay? So from this I got n and n can cancel out. So if I reciprocal it, I got r d theta by dr as cos of n theta minus sin of n theta. Now this is nothing but this is 10 phi and this is nothing but minus cot of n theta. See, I was talking about this situation only, that's why I took this question. Now for minus cot of n theta, can I write it as pi by 2 minus theta? So I can write 10 phi as tan of pi by, no, plus, sorry, plus of, what is it? Yeah. Plus of n theta. In this quadrant will come. So from this can write phi as pi by 2 plus of n theta. That's it. Pi by 2 plus of n theta is the answer for this. Should I solve one more? It's a similar, no? Same thing you have to apply again and again. That's it. I can solve one more if you want. Okay. Let's solve one more, no problem. See why I'm solving more questions in this, because same thing, nothing different we have to see in next coming sessions. Oh, that's why I'm investing more time to this. Okay, let's see. R square sine of 2 theta is equals to a square, solve, find phi. So my approach is fixed, no? This is R square sine 2 theta is equals to a square. So my approach is fixed, that 2 log of r plus log of sine of 2 theta is 2 log of a. Differentiating it, I got 2 by r dr by d theta plus sine of 2 theta, differentiation of sine is cos 2 theta multiplied by 2, that is 2 theta, the differentiation 2 theta, chain rule, no? And differentiation 2 log, this is constant, it is 0. So I am taking this side, right hand side, I got this thing. So this 2 gets cancelled out. Now if I reciprocal it, I got r d theta by dr, which is minus of sine of 2 theta upon cos of 2 theta. Now this r d theta phi is nothing but your 10 phi, and this is nothing but minus 10 of 2 theta. So see, you got the same thing, 10 phi is minus 10. So what you can write it here? So 10 phi can be written as 10 of pi minus theta. So theta is 2 theta. So from this comparing both, I got it pi minus of 2 theta. Is it okay? Is it okay? So like this, they can taking log, differentiating it, reciprocating, and converting this into form. So I have taken all the type of question they can ask in the angle between the radius vector and the tangent. The thing you have to remember is how to get this side. No, if it is 10a, if minus 10a, you can write it as 10 pi minus a. If it is cot A, we can write it pi by 2 minus A. If it is minus cot A, you can write 10 pi by 2 plus A. Is it okay? So let's give some question to you. so that you can practice out. Okay, so some of you have commented that you need answers for the questions which I give, so I will try to give those. So the question you can write here is did I do this? Yeah. The first question for homework is sin theta plus cos theta. Now the most of you will do a mistake here, as you will take log r is equals to log of sin theta plus log of cos theta. Please don't do this blunder, because this is log r log of whole of sin theta plus of cos theta. No, it's not this. Okay, so find the phi for this. So the answer for this, I think I don't have solution for you here. The phi, it is pi pi 4 plus theta for this. Okay, just verify it. Okay, now if we have r is equals to 9 of cosecant square theta by 2 for this, you got I think phi as pi by pi minus theta by 2. Please let me know that whether these answers are correct. No, okay, verify them. No, did I do this? I think I did this. If I did this or not, I don't know, because I also solved these questions. No, for this I think you will be getting pi minus, phi as pi minus theta. Check this one. And the last r times 1 minus cos theta is equals to a. So for this you got phi as pi minus of theta. Please check these answers and try to solve them. No, please have a good practice on this radius vector, and you should have a very good practice on this radius vector and angle between radius vector and tangent.